Hey again, guys. Do you know what I like to do in January? I like to vote for some YouTube Hall of Famers. I got my white glove on here to give my fellow YouTubers the white glove treatment. So I'm in favor of the new rules. I just want to say that. I do like voting for less. I do like the longevity factor. I think I would just qualify this year. I was surprised when I got elected into the Hall of Fame because I didn't feel that I was doing them long enough at the time. So I think the rules are good. And let's delve in. I'm just going to go in no particular order. There were so many that I voted for last time that don't qualify. A few were on my list that I had to take off once I looked into the longevity of how long they've been on. And so I'm just going to run through this list really quickly, and they're in no particular order. So being Italian, I have to vote for a guy with this YouTube name, and that is Hitman23. I have to vote for George over at Diamond Yard Sports Cards. I have to vote for the Roger Clemens of the YouTube sports card community, NY Yanks Fan 7. Man, I can't believe he's not in yet. This needs to be his year. I'm going to vote for my man, Derek Hardball Crazy. Another guy that's hard to believe he's not in yet, and that's Jimmy Guns. I'm going to vote for Jimmy Guns. I'm going to vote for Oakland A's 915. All the way from Korea, going to vote for KBO Collections. And finally, I'm going to vote for, even though he thinks Jerry Rice is the greatest receiver and not Don Hudson, I'm going to vote for Bart's Cards.
I truly believe that Don Hudson would have been a prolific receiver in 1997 as well as 1937. Don Hudson is the best receiver of all time, and I'd call him the best player of all time.
Now, as a YouTube Hall of Famer, I get to vote for a Good Guy Award and for a Lifetime Achievement Award. Now, for my Good Guy Award, I have two guys that both deserve it. I want to vote for both of them. One is Dave Bluejacket 66, who I voted for last year. However, I know Dave is in the Hall of Fame. And there's another guy that I voted for last year, and I can't vote for him because he doesn't have the longevity. And I think he deserves recognition. So for my Good Guy Award, I'm going to vote for Sean Tieford, the Chosen Roster. Sean is such a good guy, such a great friend to this community, and sends care packages out to everybody. And if you've ever dealt with him, just a really good guy and a great member of this community. And so I'm going to vote for him because I think he deserves recognition. And for Lifetime Achievement Award, I'm going to vote for Mike Baseball Collector. I mean, who has done more in the hobby on YouTube to bring us all together and to, I mean, he created the Hall of Fame, and I don't think there's anybody over the course of their time on YouTube and in our community who's done more for our community. So, those are my votes. Thanks for watching.
Don Hudson led the NFL in receiving in 8 of his 11 seasons and averaged a touchdown catch every 5 receptions, on his way to a career total of 99.
Don's blazing speed made him hard to cover. This time, watch him take a long throw from Herbert, good for 6 points.
In Hudson's last year, he actually scored 29 points against the Lions in 13 minutes, even after their coach, Gus DeRay, ordered a second man to cover Hudson. One of the things that DeRay said after the game was, this game can be summed up in 3 words. Too much Hudson. When he retired, he had three times as many touchdown receptions as any receiver in the first 25 years of pro football. It took 44 years, long into the era when people filled the air with footballs, for someone to catch more than 99 touchdown passes in his career. Steve Largent did it.
Number 100! And that long pursuit of Don Hutson's career touchdown reception was over.
In 1963, Hutson was chosen as a charter member of the Pro Football Hall of Fame.